Now, this might be a bit of out of topic of this training, but as I went through the phase diagram, I thought it would be a good opportunity to explain what are retrograde regions, which might be a term that you might have met. And actually, it was the case for me not that long ago. I got to see this term retrograde condensate several times, and I didn't really know what it corresponded to. So I'm going to explain it to you over there. So if we take a look at this phase diagram over there that describes the evolution of some hydrocarbon, on this diagram, there are two areas over there that shows retrograde regions. So I'm going to explain how it works. So normally when you are in such a diagram, if your pressure decreases while your temperature increases, so if you move that way, then you're going to have less and less liquids, so less and less oil, and more gas. Now, if you have this mixture of hydrocarbon in your reservoir, and if your reservoir pressure is there initially and you produce, as you go then along this line over there, what's happening is that you got less and less liquids and more gas in your reservoir as you produce this way. Now, if you are in this blue region over there, let's say that your reservoir pressure initially is over there. As you can see, as you produce, so as the pressure decreases, you will cross this line because these lines, they turn this way. They all turn like that. You will cross them and you will end up moving to curves that are further on the left while you remain in this blue region. So because of that, because as the pressure decreases, you tend to cross this dashed line from right to left. What's happening is that in this area, as the pressure decreases, you tend to have more and more liquids, while when you are in this area, when the pressure decreases, you cross this dashed line from the left to the right. Therefore, in this area, when the pressure decreases, you have less and less liquids, while in this area, when the pressure decreases, you have more and more liquids. So this is why this is called a retrograde region, and this is because we have retrograde condensates that will form, meaning that they are condensates that will form as the pressure decreases, which is usually the opposite that is happening. As the pressure decreases, you have less and less liquids and more gas. So this region over there in blue is called the isothermal retrograde region. So meaning it's a retrograde region when you move at constant temperature. So when you decrease pressure at constant temperature. And this green region over there is the isobaric retrograde regions. So meaning that you're going to have retrograde condensates that form if you change the temperature at constant pressure. So I hope this clarifies what is retrograde region and therefore what is retrograde condensates.